Hi guys, thank God it's Friday and we are here once again at our Betta Fish Rocks. This Betta Fish is already good for harvest. I mean, we can already display this at the pet store and I'm selecting the beautiful ones and they are looking good. For those of you who really would like to buy our fishes, I have to admit that I really don't have that luxury of time to ship all this to other countries and even nationwide. But for those who are just right here in our place in Zamboanga City, you can visit our pet store, Koi and Pets. It's located at Sukabon, Zamboanga City, and you can avail of this good quality of betta. By the way, last week we have cleaned our filter box of our koi pond. I'm glad that many of those who have viewed to our videos have made a comment, and it's a healthy discussion about how we gonna maintain a good koi pond, how we gonna maintain our filtration box, how we gonna clean our filter box and filter pads. So that is why I'm glad and thank you guys for your comment, and I'm so glad that those who are not yet into, you know, keeping koi are also encouraged with our discussions. Today I'm going to update about the betta fry that we have loaded just a month ago. So come on, we will go there. By the way, aside from the betta fish, we also recommend that you will breed mollies, because mollies are easy to care. I have here breeder mollies and they are already producing many babies. I've just loaded them here, few pairs, but they are having plenty of babies now. And this is one of the things that also very important. If you have a pet store, you will breed a lot of live bearers, because live bearers are easy to also breed. You look at this. Wow, they are nice. So they are due to deliver babies, and they are just so gorgeous. Okay, you will see that some of them have lyre tail, or we call it double tail, yet we cannot just catch them. So, you know, this tank is intended for our goldfish, but few months ago the robbers robbed all our breeder goldfish. And someone asked, were you still not able to breed breeder goldfish? My answer is yes. I am quite apprehensive to put goldfish here, because goldfish are slow swimmers. They can be catch easily. So that's why I'm putting light bearers, the mollies, to be here, because the robbers could not just catch them so easily. And they are so effective, especially that this place is an open space direct to the sunlight, and they need really a lot of, you know, sunlight. And we are just cleaning this regularly, and the babies are just here. They're hiding in the plants and multiplying so rapidly. So this is the update that we can give you. Of course, we gonna proceed to our betta fry. So guys, as you can recall, we uploaded a video about how to grow this betta fry and how to prevent them from dying. And we said that after how many days from hatch, we're gonna transfer them to a bigger place. And this is the result now. We transfer them, and there are a lot of fries that are actually here. We will check their conditions and their sizes. sorry, the reflection of the sun made us difficult to show this to the camera, but I'd like to just catch some of them. Just check their sizes. They're smaller, they are bigger. Some of them have grown so fast. And somebody, maybe you can suggest what camera we are going to use to combat the reflection, because we cannot film directly because of the reflection of the sun rays. But these fishes are really growing so fast. They don't have uniform sizes. These are the baby betta that we have loaded here in this bigger tank. This betta will be individually placed in a separate container maybe 2 or 3 weeks from now. We'll proceed to the bottling of this betta. This is the time when we individually place them in an individual container. We are using bottles. And if you haven't seen our video how to cut the bottle, you just browse, or maybe I will just provide an end screen of this video on how to cut bottles. Perfect cut! I'm so glad that these betta fishes are already big. So there are plenty. There are more than 500 fry that are in here. So this is a good business, and I'd like to encourage everyone to continue on breeding. And tomorrow, it's Saturday, I will show you, or I will share with you, how we gonna make a DIY wooden fish pond. How we gonna do it that we can more or less have a less consumption of our electricity. If you haven't yet subscribed, you may hit that notification bell so that you will be notified of our upcoming videos. So please continue to watch our videos, and please don't forget to like and share, only here at Dexter's World.